Hypertension. Hypertension is defined as persistently elevated arterial blood pressure. It is divided to four categories. Normal, which is less than 120 over 80. Elevated blood pressure, which is from 120 to 129 over less than 80. Stage 1, which is from 130 to 139 over 80 to 89. Stage 2, which is more than or equal 140 over more than or equal 90. The hypertension is divided based on etiology to two types. Primary hypertension, which is results from unknown pathophysiological etiology. Secondary hypertension, which is results from a comorbid disease or drug. For example, if diseases are chronic kidney disease, Cushing syndrome, parathyroid disease, and medications like non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, corticosteroids, estrogen-containing oral contraceptives. Goal of therapy, to maintain blood pressure less than 130 over 80. The treatment is divided to non-pharmacological treatment like weight reduction, sodium restriction, aerobic physical activity, and smoking cessation. Pharmacological treatment. The hypertension is treated by many classes of medications, four of them considered as first-line therapy. The rest of classes considered as second-line treatment. Let's start. Angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors like brindopril, captopril. These medications inhibit ACE enzyme in renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system. RAS system is a hormone system essential for regulation of blood pressure and fluid balance. The liver secretes angiotensinogen. The angiotensinogen converted to angiotensin 1 by renin secreted by kidneys. The angiotensin 1 converted to angiotensin 2 by angiotensin converting enzyme. Finally, the angiotensin 2 causes vasoconstriction, sodium and fluid retention in kidneys, aldosterone secretion, adrenal and extra adrenal tissue, so sodium and water retention also. Their side effects are non-protective cuff, angioedema, hyperkalemia, hypersensitivity reaction, increased insulin resistance, acute kidney failure, hypotension, anemia. We have to monitor potassium level, renal function, liver function, complete blood count. ACE inhibitors are category C in first trimester during pregnancy and D in second and third trimesters. ACE inhibitors are contraindicated in patients with history of angioedema, current use of L-skyrin, or concurrent use of potassium supplements or potassium-sparing diuretics. They are metabolized by liver and excreted by urine and feces. Most of them are diazepam. Angiotensin II receptors blockers, like valsartan, candesartan. ARBs are directly blocking the angiotensin II receptor, preventing vasoconstriction and aldosterone release. They do not affect bradykinin. Their side effects are hyperkalemia, renal insufficiency, orthostatic hypotension, increased insulin resistance. We have to monitor potassium level and renal function. ARBs are category C in first trimester during pregnancy and D in second and third trimesters. Most of them are metabolized by liver and excreted by urine and feces. They are not dialyzable. Calcium channel blockers. There are two subclasses. Dihydropyridines like amlodipine and non-dihydropyridines like diltiazem. They block the calcium channels in the heart and in smooth muscles, so this causes relaxation and dilating arterioles. Their side effects are constipation, CNS side effects, flushing, peripheral edema, tachycardia, bradycardia, heart block. We have to monitor heart rate. They are contraindicated in heart failure with reduced ejection fraction, hypersensitivity reaction, and sick sinus syndrome. They are category C during pregnancy. They are metabolized by liver and excreted by urine and feces. They are not dialyzable. Thiazide diuretics. Diuretics are four types, and thiazide diuretics are considered as first line, like hydrochlorothiazide and indapamide. Thiazide diuretics inhibit sodium and chloride reabsorption, causing excretion of sodium, chloride, and water. Their side effects are hypokalemia, hypomagnesemia, hyperuricemia, hyperglycemia, hypercholesterolemia, and sexual dysfunction. We have to monitor electrolytes level, uric acid level. Chlorothalidone is category C during pregnancy, and the rest of them are category B. Most of them metabolized by liver and excreted by urine. They are not dialyzable. Beta blockers. Beta blockers are three generations. First generation, non-selective beta blockers like propranolol. Second generation, beta 1 selective like metoprolol. Third generation, either non-selective beta blockers like cardiovilol or beta 1 selective with vasodilation like betaxolol. The exact hypotensive mechanism is unknown, but may involve decreased cardiac output through negative chronotropic and anotropic effects on the heart and inhibition of renin release from the kidneys. Their side effects are altered lipids, increased blood glucose, central nervous system side effects, bradycardia, atrioventricular conduction abnormalities, cold extremities, and insomnia. They mask hypoglycemia signs like tachycardia and tremor, except sweating. Abrupt cessation of beta blockers produce rebound hypertension, unstable angina, myocardial infarction, or even death in patients with coronary diseases. To avoid this, taper gradually over 1 to 2 weeks. We have to monitor heart rate, QT interval. They are contraindicated in asthmatic patients, patients who have bradycardia, Raynaud phenomena. Atenolol is category D during pregnancy, and rest of them are category C. Most of them metabolized by liver and excreted by urine and feces. Most of them are not dialyzable. Loop diuretics, like furosemide, they are not ideal antihypertensive agents unless relief of edema is needed, and in chronic kidney disease patients when estimated glomerular filtration rate is less than 30. They inhibit sodium, chloride, and potassium reabsorption, causing excretion of sodium, chloride, magnesium, calcium, and water. Their side effects are hyperuricemia, hypocalcemia, hypokalemia, hypochloremia, azotemia, headache, ototoxicity, and hepatic encephalopathy. We have to monitor electrolytes, fluid state, and renal function. They are contraindicated in anuria, history of hypersensitivity to them or sulfonamides, hepatic encephalopathy, and severe electrolytes depletion. They are category C during pregnancy. They are metabolized by liver and excreted by urine. They are not dialyzable. Potassium-sparing diuretics, like amiloride. They inhibit sodium reabsorption. This reduces the excretion of potassium, calcium, magnesium, and hydrogen, and increase the excretion for sodium and water. Their side effects are hyperkalemia, anorexia, diarrhea, headache, nausea, and vomiting. We have to monitor electrolytes. Regarding pregnancy category, amiloride is category B and trimetrine is category C. They should be avoided in hemodialysis patients. Aldosterone antagonist diuretics, like spironolactone. These agents are also considered potassium-sparing diuretics. They block the aldosterone receptors in central nervous system, kidneys, heart and vasculature, so inhibits sodium and water retention and inhibits vasoconstriction. Spironolactone diminishes the cardiac remodeling that occurs in heart failure. Their side effects are hyperkalemia, gynecomastia. Spironolactone is category C during pregnancy, and eplerenone is category B. Metabolized in liver and kidneys and excreted in urine and feces. They are not dialyzable. Directed renin inhibitor, which include elsekerin, it directly inhibits the renin enzyme, so inhibit conversion of angiotensinogen to angiotensin. It may cause diarrhea, cough, rash, and hyperkalemia. It is category C during first trimester of pregnancy and category D during second and third trimester. It is metabolized by liver, excreted by kidney, and it is not dialyzable. Alpha 1 blockers, like prazosin and tirazosin. They attach to peripheral alpha 1 receptors, inhibiting the uptake of catecholamines in smooth muscles and cause vasodilation. Their side effects are orthostatic hypotension, dizziness, palpitations, sodium and water retention. They are only used in combination with primary antihypertensive agents and may be considered as second-line agents in patients with benign prostatic hyperplasia. They are metabolized by liver, excreted by feces and urine, and they are not dialyzable. Central alpha-2 agonists and other centrally acting drugs like clonidine and methyldopa. They stimulate alpha-2 adrenergic receptors in the brain, which reduces sympathetic outflow consequently, so decrease heart rate, cardiac output, total peripheral resistance, plasma renin activity, and baroreceptor reflexes. Their side effects are sodium and fluid retention, depression, orthostatic hypotension, dizziness, dry mouth, anticholinergic effects, hemolytic anemia, and hepatitis. Methyldopa and guanfacine are category B during pregnancy, and clonidine is category C. They are metabolized by liver, excreted by feces and urine, and most of them are not dialyzable. Plan for treatment. In normal blood pressure people, it is recommended to reassess blood pressure every year. In elevated blood pressure or stage 1 hypertension, plus estimated 10 years atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease risk less than 10%, it is recommended to treat with non-pharmacological therapy plus repeat blood pressure evaluation within 3 to 6 months. In stage 1 hypertension, who have an estimated 10-year atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease risk of 10% or higher, it is recommended to treat with combination of non-pharmacological therapy plus antihypertensive drug therapy, ACE inhibitors or ARBs or calcium channel blockers or thiazide diuretics, plus repeat blood pressure evaluation in 1 month. In stage 2 hypertension, it is recommended to treat with combination of non-pharmacological therapy plus 2 first-line antihypertensive drug therapies, thiazide diuretics, plus ACE inhibitors or ARBs, plus repeat blood pressure evaluation in 1 month. In patients with hypertension plus heart failure with reduced ejection fraction, it is recommended to treat according to guidelines directed medical therapy, and classes used are ACE inhibitors or ARBs, plus beta blockers, plus aldosterone antagonists in selected patients, plus or minus diuretics only if there is symptoms. Hydralazine and azoxystrobin nitrate for African Americans. See heart failure video for details. In patients with hypertension plus heart failure with preserved ejection fraction, it is recommended to treat with ACE inhibitors or ARBs plus beta blockers plus diuretics only if there is symptoms. See heart failure video for details. In patients with hypertension plus diabetes mellitus, it is recommended to treat with ACE inhibitors or ARBs plus or minus calcium channel blockers plus or minus thiazide diuretics plus or minus beta blockers add on according to blood pressure goal. In patients with hypertension plus chronic kidney disease, it is recommended to treat with ACE inhibitors or ARBs plus or minus thiazide diuretics, loop diuretics if there is edema, plus or minus non-dihydropyridine calcium channel blockers plus or minus beta blockers. In patients with hypertension plus chronic kidney disease with albuminuria, it is recommended to treat with ACE inhibitors or ARBs. In patients with hypertension plus previous history of stroke, it is recommended to treat with thiazide diuretics plus or minus ACE inhibitors or ARBs. Special patients groups. Pregnancy. The medications that are safely used in pregnancy are methyldopa or nifedipine and or labetalol. Elderly, all classes can be used based on comorbidities and clinical judgment, but thiazides and calcium channel blockers are more effective as monotherapy. Children. The medications that are safely used in children are ACE inhibitors, ARBs, calcium channel blockers, or thiazide diuretics, and ACE inhibitors or ARBs if chronic kidney disease or diabetes patients. Chronic kidney disease patients, we have to be cautious that ACE inhibitors and beta blockers need dose adjustment. Thiazide diuretics do not need dose adjustment, but they are contraindicated of serum creatinine more than 2.5. Potassium-sparing diuretics are contraindicated of GFR less than 10 because they raise potassium level. African Americans without heart failure or chronic kidney disease, thiazide diuretics or calcium channel blockers plus ACE inhibitors or ARBs or beta blockers.